I see a lot of men flirting and they do it all wrong. So like I've seen men who will think that, you know, just because so what will happen is like people will start teasing a woman and then it will go they'll go overboard with it. They're like, oh, because it worked the first time, they're just gonna milk it to death. They're gonna tease her to a point where she gets really, really pissed off or where she really starts to feel like, oh, is there something wrong with me? And so it's good to tease them, but there's a boundary, you know, there's a limit to how much you do that. And as a rule, I would say for every compliment or every tease you do, you should give at least one compliment. So for, I think the ratio has to be equal. If you give her one compliment, maybe you can, for one compliment, you can tease twice, but no more than that. Because you want her to feel loved. You want her to feel like you like her, but at the same time, you're not needy enough to supplicate her. It's like, what you're trying to do is, if you just keep giving compliments after compliments after compliments, then she would feel like, oh, he likes me, but now she doesn't know how far she can take it. She doesn't know if you're needy, you're supplicating, you're going to kiss her ass to death. So by throwing those teas in between, you're saying, hey, I like you, but guess what? I can distance myself from you anytime I want. And then that, you know, that whole thing goes, that whole thing is what makes her feel like, oh, he likes me, but oh, he just teased me. Oh, what's going on here? He doesn't like me that much. So she starts to feel like, you know, it gives you a perfect balance, and that's what women enjoy. Then they enjoy, because women also want to chase you. And if you keep doing one or the other on the extreme, if you tease them too much, if you give them too much compliments, it's gone. At the same time, if you're doing all these things and you're not making an eye contact, you're done. Because that's how women see if you're confident or not. I'm talking to you and I want to say something to you, but I don't want to make an eye contact. You're going to notice that I'm insecure, because that's what people do. When you say something and you're not sure about that, you usually avoid eye contact. But when you're sure about something, you usually look other people in their eyes and then you talk. And so that's what you wanna do. When you talk, you wanna make an eye contact and deliver, whether it's your compliment or your tease, you wanna do it with eye contact. And while you're doing all these things, you also wanna start touching them. Because if you're not touching them, then the sexual chemistry, the physical chemistry is not taking place. So flirting involves all these elements. You're talking to her now, you're giving her compliments, you're teasing her, and you start touching her. You know, you could be talking to her about anything. I could be talking to you about like flying to Hawaii right now, and all of a sudden I go, oh my God, you have really nice hair. Wow, it's pretty cool. So I'm getting back to the Hawaii, when was in Hawaii, boom, you're back. But now she's like, oh wow, he's noticing me as a woman. Like, you know, you're enjoying her body, her looks, her feminine traits, and that turns her on. So you're not just another guy who's there to socialize with her. You're a guy who enjoys her, who likes everything about her, likes to tease her, and also wants to get sexual with her. Now, in order to get sexual with her, you will also have to have the right level of energy. The minute you start touching her, when you initiate your touching, you have to start with high energy, and then you calibrate your energy based on whether you're sexual or you're not. So, you know, your energy is going to keep going up and down depending on your phase of interaction with her. And animation is another thing, that when you're talking to them, when you're teasing them, a wrong expression on your face, a wrong body language can totally kill it for you. You know, it's like if I'm talking to you right now and I'm just like, you know, I need you to know this. This is not an authority figure. So if I'm trying to present myself as an authority, I have to sit, you know, I have to have that authority posture, make eye contact the way an authority figure would do. But when you're out there, you don't want to be thinking about all these things. You will do things based on who you are. And that's why it's very important that when you get training or when you start building your lifestyle or you rearrange your body language and stuff like that, you ask yourself who you are. What is it that you want to present to the world? So you don't go out and sit like, oh, I want to be an alpha now. I want to be a submissive guy now. No. This is who I am. I just want people to know that in general, I am an alpha guy. This is how I usually sit. This is how I usually talk. Like for me, if you wake me up at 3 a.m, this is exactly the way I talk. My tonality and the way I talk to people does not change from hour to hour, from venue to venue. This is who I am. You wake me at 3 a.m, you'll find the same balance of alpha and the cool guy that you'll find any other time. And those are the things you want to master. If you have these things, you're implementing these things, your flirting is going in a direction where you will get into a sexual relationship with women.